I'm Kevin Hogan, Executive Director of Auction Services here at Rock Island Auction Company, and I would like to introduce you to our magnificent September 13th, 14th, and 15th Premier Firearms Auction. In terms of historic, fresh, rare, and investment quality firearms, it truly does not get any better than this upcoming sale. Throughout the sale, and if you have watched any other of our videos from this series, you will hear me talk about several very well-known firearms collectors. One of these collectors also just so happens to be the world's foremost expert on the Colt government model. He happens to have written the definitive work on said subject, and he also shares that same passion for Smith & Wesson revolvers. He is the esteemed collector and author, Mr. William H.D. Goddard. We at Rock Island Auction Company are very proud to have been selected to market and sell Mr. Goddard's collection, and I would just like to take a few minutes and walk you through a few key pieces before me. I will start with my single favorite piece in the sale, not because it's the most expensive, but because I share Mr. Goddard's passion for Smith & Wesson revolvers. And it's one of the finest and most well-documented Smith & Wessons I have ever had the privilege of handling. I'm talking about this Gustav Jung factory engraved, factory gold inlaid Smith & Wesson 44 Frontier revolver, which was initially commissioned for the 1893 World Columbian Exhibition. It was a practice at the grand exhibitions of the 19th century for manufacturers of all products to display to the world their firm's capabilities in the form of the newest technology, the newest manufacturing methods, and the most lavish embellishments. Even today, the majority of superior grade, investment quality firearms, which are more often than not lavishly engraved, stemmed from one of these grand exhibitions. Colt, Remington, and Smith & Wesson all implemented such practices. And this is one of those guns. However, taking it a step further, this gun is not only factory engraved by the greatest 19th century arms engraver, Gustav Jung, but it's also factory gold inlaid, as well as featuring a pair of snakeskin wrapped grips, which we attribute to Tiffany & Company. Larger and grander than the other world fairs, the Columbian Exhibition in 1893 held in Chicago ran for 6 months and was attended by more than 27 million people and showed the world American exceptionalism at its best. Compounding all that wonderful and rich history, this particular revolver was presented in 1907 to the Sheriff of Goldfield, Nevada, Mr. Claude Inman. Decades after the 1893 World's Fair, an article by Kip Chase entitled "Redonda Recalls the Days of Old with Wyatt Earp Gold Mining" was published in a local newspaper. The article details the life of Claude Inman during his days as the police chief of Goldfield, Nevada, and with the article is a photograph of Inman holding the Smith & Wesson and the holster. The caption reads, "He is holding the six-shooter he used while police chief in Goldfield, Nevada. Inman was hired by mine owners to clean up the town in the days when Goldfield was a gold-hungry frontier town. The mine owners paid Inman $10,000 per month, and their investment paid off. Inman was credited for cleaning up the town that was plagued with outlaws. He raided dope dens, tracked down high graders, had run-ins with the brothers John and James McNamara. The brothers would later, of course, blow up the Los Angeles Times building in 1910 and met the famous outlaw Wyatt Earp." Rarely can you document either of these histories with such a firearm, let alone both of them. From the Chicago World's Fair to the Gold Rush, from the Columbian Exhibition to the hip of a sheriff, the romance does not get any deeper. The other pistol which sums up the collection of Mr. Goddard is this. A one-of-a-kind documented Colt 1900 sight safety Browning slide lock prototype semi-automatic pistol. This pistol was the prototype for the side lock feature that was adapted by Colt and the U.S. Army and used on every semi-automatic Colt pistol manufactured, as well as almost every semi-automatic pistol in use today. Colt used this incredibly rare baseline and original and completely intact Colt 1900 pistol, which still retains its desirable and original sight safety configuration. The 1900 is a very significant pistol in the field of semi-automatics, as it was John Browning's first successful automatic pistol design, which was later manufactured by Colt and was the direct link to the Model 1911 pistol. Colt only produced 3,500 of these pistols from 1900 to 1903. One of the weaknesses identified during the U.S. Army test of the Model 1900 pistol was that it took two hands to get the slide back into action after the last shot was fired. So John Browning developed an engineer to fix specifically to resolve that problem using this pistol, serial number 1433. This specific pistol is referenced, photographed, and described on page 66 and 67 of the book Government Models by William H.D. Goddard. Other firearms of note include this 1 of 10 Smith & Wesson U.S. Treasury Department shipped new model number 3 revolver. How about this for rare and historic? A cased presentation from the Prime Minister of Israel to General Beadle Smith, IMI double action military revolver. Only 52 of these revolvers were manufactured in 1952 and 1953 and all given as presents. The revolver is a copy of the Smith & Wesson Model's 1917 45 caliber revolver. However, the IMI revolver is chambered in the 9mm Parabellum cartridge. General Smith started his military career as a private in the Indiana National Guard and rose to coordinate the entire planning of the invasion of North Africa and Normandy in World War II. Winston Churchill nicknamed him the Bulldog because of his tenacity in handling problems. Eisenhower once described Smith as the general manager of the war, and he signed the Italian surrender document in September of 1943 on Eisenhower's behalf. In 1945, he headed the Allied group which accepted the unconditional surrender of Germany, an extremely rare IMI manufactured revolver presented to one of the World War II's greatest generals from the Prime Minister of Israel. If ever there was a piece destined for a museum, this might be it. But this is the depth that exists within this collection. How about a flat mint Smith & Wesson first model triple lock double action target revolver? Or these near new government models? Or these fantastic third model Russians? Or an even equally rare high condition US Navy 1900 sight safety? It's hard to imagine the entire scope of this collection, but I hope this was enough to get the idea. So save the date, September 13th, 14th, and 15th. For more information, visit our website, www.rockislandauction.com. For instant updates, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Think, 2,700 pieces in 3 days, and this is the tip of the spear. Plan to attend the preview, September 12th. Doors open at 10 a.m. It's one thing to look at these items in a catalog, and it's a whole nother experience to hold them in your hand. Don't forget, we have an after preview party that goes till 8. Hope to see you then.